Welcome to this new Aurora HDR video tutorial by Roze Photo. My name is Mark de Roy. I'm a Dutch-based photographer, and today I'm going to show you how to merge photos in Aurora HDR 2019. Last year I went to Iceland. I made fantastic photos, and this photo was also made there. Enjoy watching this video, and please leave a comment below this video to let us know what you think about it. I opened those three photos I took in Iceland. It was a beautiful landscape, and the most appealing to me of this landscape was the S-curve you can see here in between the mountain on the left and the mountain on the right. I took it in three shots, a normal exposure, a minus two exposure, and a plus two exposure. And in this video I will show you what I do when I open those photos in Aurora HDR. And I will show you the process, how it goes. So I didn't prepare anything, because then it always looks like, he did it in 1 or 2 minutes and it's done. Maybe it's done in 1 or 2 minutes, maybe not. Sometimes also for me, it's kind of looking for the right way to post-process this photo. So what I'm gonna do first is I enable the auto alignment. I took the photo from a tripod, but suppose there was a little movement, the auto alignment will make it right. I also enable the ghost reduction. I know that this photo, the overexposed photo, was taken with 1/10 of a second. The underexposed photo was with 1/160th of a second. So probably there's some movement in the grass in the foreground. So because of that, I want the minus two photo as a reference image, because that photo was taken in the fast way possible, 1/160th of a second. So I expect to see not so much movement in this photo. And that also makes sure that the grass in the foreground will be sharp. I don't think there's too much movement, so I leave this in medium. And I also want to remove the chromatic aberration reduction. I'm not sure if it's there, the chromatic aberration. Maybe it is here in the borders of the mountains. But if you turn it on and those purple or green edges are not there, it's not an issue to turn it on. So I basically always turn this option on. So I click on Create HDR, and the photos will be merged. So what I want to do with these photos, I definitely want to get some extra details in the snow in the mountain that was not very clear in the normal exposure. So that's what I want to do. And I also want details in the foreground. So I don't want the grass to be very dark. So with the photos I took, it should be possible. The information is there, so I don't think it's a problem to get a good result. So it almost took 1 minute to merge the photos, but this is how it looks right away, and I'm pretty amazed by how it looks like, because it already looks pretty good. And to show you the difference, this is the normal exposed photo, this is the HDR photo. So as you can see, much more details here in the top of the mountains. Actually, you're losing a lot of details in the original photo, but also the foreground is very nice. I like the colors also, the green, that's always nice in the photos of Iceland, the dark mountains with the bright green, so that works really well. So let's check what we can do to make this photo even better. I press J in the keyboard to see if there is any under or overexposure. There is overexposure in the sky, so I will put the highlights in minus. It also makes sure that I get a little bit more details in the snow, as you can see. So I'll do it again. So the top of the mountains are also improving. And yeah, it's still a little bit overexposed here, but to be honest, I really don't mind too much. I can remove it with a brush if I want, but I think it's fine, and I also like how the mountains are and how the snow is visible. So there's also some underexposure here in the foreground. I want to remove that, or at least a little bit. I want to see a little bit more detail, so I pull up the shadows. It's still there. I have to go really far. That's too much to me, because I don't like the effect in the rest of the photo. So what I do is I pull it up until about 30, so there is still some underexposure. It's black. It doesn't really disturb me. Actually, I like the contrast in the photo, so maybe I will leave it like this. I only want to see what happens if I pull up the blacks. Yeah, that doesn't work either. No. So for now, I leave it like this. And sometimes people say the histogram has to be in, well, the middle, so it cannot hit the left or the right side, and that's actually also the purpose of HDR, of course. But in the end, to me, it matters more how the photo look like, and if there's a little bit over or under exposure in the photo, and it is the way I like it, I don't mind. So it's really a choice you have to make, if you really want to see details everywhere in the photo, or if you think it's okay to lose some details and in the end that improves the contrast of the photo. So let's see what I can do with the colors. I think the colors are already very nice. The vibrance doesn't make it better. It makes the mountain very bluish. So now a little bit is okay. Saturation, that's a little bit too much. So I'm always very careful with those sliders, because it can be too much pretty quick. Color contrast is a slider I like a lot. I like color contrast, and especially in a photo like this, where you have a lot of green tones and more bluish tones in the background, it's something I like. It also gives the photo a little bit more of depth, because you have first some green, then some black, green, and well, that goes on, and that improves it, the sense of depth of the photo. Then the slider I really like in Aurora HDR 2019 is the HDR Smart Structure. It doesn't work for all the photos, but I think for a photo like this, it can help. It gives some extra detail and sharpness in the whole photo, basically everywhere where there's structure. So that's basically everything except the sky here. So let's see the before and after. I like it. So that's also an improvement. Image radiance, I don't use it a lot. Also for this photo, I don't think it's nice, but sometimes it can be very nice. For landscapes, it makes it more, a little bit more blurry and more like a fantasy landscape. In this case, I don't want to get that result, so I keep the amount in 0. What else do we have? HDR detail boost. Well, I think there are already enough details, so I don't think this is gonna help the photo a lot. No, not at all. So I keep this all in 0. Glow, I don't want it. The adjustable gradient is also very nice. So as you can see, there's still some overexposure in the sky. If you want to remove it, it's easy to use an adjustable gradient from the top with the exposure in the minus, like this. As you can see, it also has an effect in the mountains, and that's because the gradient by default goes into the middle of the photo, but I'm very happy it's possible to change the orientation. So if I only want the gradient to be applied to the sky and maybe a little bit of the top of the mountains, I can put it like this, and as you can see, the overexposure is gone. Let me check. Yeah, that helps. So it only makes basically the top of the sky a little bit darker. So that's a way to remove the overexposure here in the top without changing the rest of the landscape too much. So this is what I like. Another way of doing it is not using the exposure, but the highlights, of course. So maybe that's even better. Let's check it. Yeah, I think this, the result is kind of the same. All right. Yeah, that's basically it, I guess. I'm really happy with how the photo looks like. I got what I want. I want the fresh, bright green in the foreground. I want more details here in the mountain and in the snow. I also like the green and the black that it's changing all the time. So green, black, and here's a bit of green and then black again. So that's nice. And that's it. I don't want to use a vignette for this photo. It's possible, but I don't like it too much. I like the grass too much, so I don't want to make it darker. So this is it. And to me, this is the final result. I'm happy with it. Hopefully you learned something new from this tutorial. Leave a comment below if you have any questions, any requests of new tutorials. Also nice to hear. So thank you for watching this video, and hopefully see you next time.